Yeah, it's time.
Welcome, everybody.
Yeah, there you go.
Welcome and Shabbat Shalom. We are so happy to have you all here with us tonight for TEFTY Shabbat. For those who don't know, TEFTY is our high school youth group here at Emanu, and some of our teens have been working hard to prepare a service for all of us tonight, which, of course, the rabbis greatly appreciate, being the Shabbat right after High Holy Days. We are all so excited to be here with them. The service packets in your hand were made especially by teens for you tonight. So the service is not only for those who are young, but for those who are young at heart. We hope you will enjoy the service, and we begin with our opening song on the first page, Circle Game, by Joni Mitchell.
Join with me. Yesterday, a child came out to wonder, caught a dragonfly inside a jar. Fearful when the sky was full of thunder, and tearful at the falling of a star. And the seasons, they go around and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came, and go round and round and round in the circle game. Together! Then the child moved 10 times round the seasons, skated over 10 clear frozen streams. Words like, when you're older, must go please him, and promises of someday make his dream. And the seasons, they go around and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look from behind, from where we came, and go round and round and round in the circle game. 16 springs and 16 summers gone now. Cartwheels turn to cartwheels through the town. They tell him, take your turn, it won't be long now, till you drag your feet to slow the drivers down. And the seasons, and the seasons, they go around and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came, and go round and round and round in the circle game. Years spin by, and now the boy is 20. Though his dreams have lost some grandeur coming true, there'll be new dreams, maybe better dreams, and plenty before the last revolving year is through. And the seasons, they go around and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captured up on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came, and go round and round and round in the circle game. And go round and round and round in the circle gate.
It is now my honor to turn our service over to Michelle Barmeyer, TEFTY's RCVP, Religious and Cultural Vice President, who created this beautiful service for us tonight, and to Marissa Papel, last year's RCVP and this year's TEFTY President.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Ahad Rishon Yetzirah V'Tzivanu L'Hagat Ner Shel Shabbat.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kiddushanu V'Mitzvotav V'Tzivanu L'Hadlik Ner L'Hadlik Ner Shel Shabbat.
The meaning of life is contained in every single expression of life. It is present in the infinity of forms and phenomena that exist in all of creation. It differs from man to man, from day to day, from hour to hour.
The meaning of life is not to be discovered only after death in some hidden, mysterious realm. On the contrary, it can be found by eating the succulent fruit of the tree of life and by living in the here and now as fully and creatively as we can. Please rise.
La 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 la.
Because children grow up, we think a child's purpose is to grow up. But a child's purpose is to be a child. Nature doesn't disdain what lives only for a day. It pours the whole of itself into each moment. We don't value the lily less for not being made of flint and built to last. Life's bounty is in its flow. Later is too late. Where is the song when it's been sung? The dance when it's been danced? It's only we humans who want to own the future too.
We persuade ourselves that the universe is modestly employed in unfolding our destination. We note the haphazard chaos of history by the day, by the hour, but there is something wrong with the picture. Where is the unity, the meaning of nature's highest creation? Surely those millions of little streams of accident and of willfulness have their correct in the vast underground river, which without a doubt is carrying us to the place where we're expected. But there is no such place. That's why it's called utopia. The death of a child has more meaning than the death of armies of nations. Was the child happy where he lived? That is the proper question, the only question. If we can't arrange our own happiness, it is a conceit beyond vulgarity to arrange the happiness of those who come after us.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
We must keep our hopes alive. We must keep our voices high. We must hold each other tight. We must stand up in the light and be light.
We must spread our love around. We must feel the spiritual sound. And we must work until peace has come. We must love and live as one.
When you give yourself permission to communicate what matters to you in every situation, you will have peace. Despite rejection or disapproval, putting a voice to your soul helps you to let go of the negative energy of fear and regret. Please read responsibly. I wish I had the courage to live a life true to myself, not the life others expected of me. I wish I had the courage to express my feelings.
I wish I had stayed in touch with my friends.
I wish that I had let myself be happier. Please rise.
Shema.
It takes a whole life to learn how to die. Everyone hustles his life along and is troubled by a longing for the future and weariness of the present. Please read responsibly. It is not that we have a short time to live, but we waste a lot of it.
Life is long enough and sufficiently generous. Life is long, we know how to use it.
We are living as if destined to live forever. Our own fatality never occurs to us.
We act like mortals of all that we fear, like immortals of all that we desire.
How late it is to begin really to live just when life must end.
How stupid to forget our mortality.
More toxic to the soul is toiling away toward goals laid out by another. All those who call you to themselves draw you away from yourself.
Shelter us beneath thy wings, O Adonai. Keep us from all harmful things, O Adonai. Keep us safe throughout the night, O Adonai. Keep us safe in thy wings, O Adonai. Till we wake with morning's light, teach us, God, all wrong from right. Amen. We take a moment to meditate on the words of Lahashkivenu. Amen.
There are two ways of being happy. We must either diminish our wants or augment our means. Either may do. The result is the same, and it is for each man to decide for himself and to do that which happens to be easier.
Most people would rather be certain they're miserable than risk being happy. The art of being happy lies in the power of extracting happiness from common things.
Please rise. Please be seated. Simplicity brings balance, freedom, and joy. When we begin to live simply and experience these benefits, we begin to ask the next question. Where else in my life can I remove distraction and simply focus on the essential? Please take this time of reflection to consider what factors you feel are important in the process of living a life of fulfillment.
If you search for tenderness, it isn't hard to do. You can have the love you need to live. If you look for truthfulness, you might just as well be blind. It always seems to be so hard to hear. Honesty is such a lonely word. Everyone is so untrue. Honesty is hardly ever heard, but mostly what I need from you. I can always find someone to say they sympathize if I wear my heart out on my sleeve. But if I don't want some pretty face to tell me pretty lies, all I want is someone to believe. Honesty is such a lonely word. Everyone is so untrue. Honesty is hardly to ever hurt, but mostly what I need from you. I can find a lover, I can find a friend, I can have security until the bitter end. Anyone can comfort me with promises again. I know everybody. Honesty is such a lonely word. Everyone is so untrue. Honesty is hardly ever heard, but mostly what I need from you.
The phrase, love one another, is so wise. By loving one another, we invest in each other and in ourselves. Perhaps someday, when we need someone to care for us, it may not come from the person we expect, but from the person we least expect. It may be our sons or daughter-in-laws, our neighbors, friends, cousins, stepchildren, or stepparents, whose love for us has assigned them to the honorable yet dangerous position of caregiver. The emphasis and the reason for a pure humility is to result in love for others, not always necessarily the belittlement of self. When there is pride and self-righteousness and being pretentiously too far above, generally, one has a difficult time reaching the compassionate side of love for others, the side that understands, or at least attempts to understand, I am aware that I am not so far from falling in the same way. Humility seeks to understand and sometimes even relate, and in result, the love lovingly, properly, effectively wills the removal of the destructive sins of another as from oneself. I would now like to invite up Rabbi Hayon.
This is the time when we take a minute to offer some words of healing on behalf of those folks in our congregation and our circles of care and concern in our own families, in our neighborhoods, in our schools, that are somehow incomplete on this Shabbat, who could use the presence of a loving community to offer prayers on their behalf. Whether we're praying for the healing of body or mind or spirit, this is the chance for us to think about them now, draw them close to us in our prayers. Think of their names and ask for God's restorative presence in their lives. So on this Shabbat, our congregational family remembers the names of these folks who are in need of healing on this Shabbat. We are thinking of Barbara Berkowitz, Marsha Block, Ricky Bluestein, Adam Bocchetto, Bradley Borden, Alan Brooks, Melba Berman, Margie Cohen, Abby Crane, Hal Davis, Karen Dubin, Harvey Dubin, Judy Engelstad, Daniel Fellman, Leslie Fenton, Robert Friedman, Ron Garfield, Leslie Goldgain, Marcine Goldman, Judy Gorwitz, Andrea Grief, David Gross, Brooks Hamilton, Frida Harrell, Ron Hodge, Elizabeth Hussman, Sarah James, Julie Kaufman, Dodie Krakauer, Rhoda Kraus, Richard Kuttner, Lucy Lawson, Herb Lesser, Vicky Samuels-Levy, Samuel Lux, Steve Meyer, Steve Miller, Michelle Morgan, Lee Naftalin, Edgar Nelson, Benjamin Ostrovsky, Janice Parg, Michael Pessis, Ellen Petrus, Elaine V. Plotkin, Dick Plum, Sophia Rauch, Robert Rosenfield, Beau Ross, Stephen Schwartz, Chaim and Jenny Siegel, Steve Sherman, Erie Arbiser-Shaki, David Silverman, Haskell Simon, Jerry Spencer, Helen Stein, Frank Tudson, Ferris Varani, Judy Wagner, Fanny Wheel, Howard Weinberg, Roger Williams, Eliyahu Simcha ben Natan Beitka, and Shalom ben Sara. Of course, the thoughts that we offer with this Mishaberach aren't just limited to the members of our congregation, so it's totally appropriate for you now to think about folks outside of our congregational family who, on whose behalf we're praying on this Shabbat. Mishaberach avoteinu v'imoteinu, Avram Yitzhak v'Yaakov, Sarah Rivka Rachel v'Leah, hu yivarech et acholim. Bischar zeh kadosh baruch hu yishmerem v'yatzilem mikol tzara u'betzuka u'mikol nega u'machala v'yishlach bracha v'atzlacha mikol ma'aseh yadam imkol Yisrael v'nomar amen. May the one who blessed our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, bless all of those in our circles of concern who are ill and need of healing on this Shabbat. May they merit from the Holy One of Blessing protection, rescue from any trouble or distress, and from any illness, minor or serious. May God send blessing and success in their every endeavor together with all Israel. And we'll say together, Amen. So since we're already offering blessings, now is a chance for us to offer a couple of other exciting milestone blessings for our congregation and for one family in particular. Where is Amy Gritz? Where is Amy? There she is. Amy, would you please stand up? So Amy is not yet, right, a couple days from now, celebrating a birthday. So we are going to offer our congregations a big sort of rush of blessings Amy's way for this birthday of hers, when she's surrounded by so many members of her family and by surrounded by this congregational family as well. We're starting a brand new year, and you're starting a brand new year in your life as well. We hope that the blessings that we prayed for as a community and as a whole Jewish people just a few days ago, a year of restoration and new starts, a year of great opportunity and blessing and goodness, a year of connectedness with God and connectedness with the people who we care most about, that those blessings will be yours as you celebrate this birthday. And so we're going to give our thanks to God who's given us our life and brought us to this joyous occasion. You'll join with me. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam shehecheyanu v'kiyemanu v'higiyanu lazman hazeh. We praise you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe. You give us life and sustain us, and have brought us to this joyous occasion. Amen. Amen. All right, Amy, you can be seated, and I'm so sorry to upstage you, but I'm going to invite your mother to please stand up now, too. So, Mom, this is Shirley. Shirley is celebrating. I wasn't going to publicize the number of Amy's birthday, but I think it's okay for me to publicize that Shirley is celebrating her 90th birthday. So, it is beautiful and appropriate for her to be celebrating this milestone birthday in the midst of so many loving members of her family who have come from far and near, from as far as, I think, is Connecticut the most far flung? Okay, so we got some Connecticut representatives spoke from here, some Dallas representatives. Anyone else I'm missing? Houston, any other sectors that need to be recognized? Okay, so far and near, all kinds of family here to celebrate with Shirley as she celebrates this great, wonderful birthday. She's also here celebrating, of course, in this circle of worship at this congregation that has been such an important spiritual home to her and her family for so many years, her involvement here at the temple, her involvement with the sisterhood as its leader for a number of years, her involvement with the Emanu elders, and I think it's also appropriate that we're celebrating on this evening of music. I know that the sounds of music and celebration and prayer are so important to you as a Jew and as a human being, that those are the things that help your soul take flight. So it is beautiful and appropriate that you have a chance to celebrate this birthday in the midst of all those who love you and who love this place so much. So it is my pleasure to ask God's blessing on you and on your joyous family as you celebrate this milestone birthday, along with all of us in this place who cherish it and you along with one another. So let's give our thanks to God for having given us our life and brought us to another milestone occasion. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, shehecheyanu v'kiyamanu v'higiyanu lazman hazeh. We praise you, O God. You have given us life and kept us alive, enabled us to reach this joyous and momentous occasion. Amen. Mazel tov. And now it's my pleasure to invite Marissa up to the Bima to offer a few words of Torah.
Have you ever wanted something so badly and were unable to have it? That is exactly how Moses felt when he couldn't go into the Promised Land. In this week's Parsha, Ha'azinu, Moses gives his final speech to the people of Israel before they head into the Promised Land without him. Moses is only able to look at the Promised Land before he dies. I can only imagine how Moses felt in that moment. He had done so many incredible things for the Jewish people, and now he was not able to celebrate their greatest achievement with them because of one mistake he made. Throughout this service, we have talked about things that you do that keep you from being happy. I think that is exactly what Moses did by not being able to go into the land of Israel. Now fast forward into the present. It's 2015. Let's imagine that Moses is alive today. What would make Moses happy about seeing the land of Israel? Would Moses be proud of all of Israel's technological advancements and how Israel is saving so many lives of Jews and non-Jews? Would Moses find that Zionism, the movement founded by Theodore Herzl, whose goal is to return Jews to Eretz Israel, is a good thing? Would Moses even consider himself a Zionist? And if so, which type of Zionist do you think he would be? Would Moses fall in love with the community aspect of Israel and that we are all a Kehila Kadosha, a holy community? Would Moses want to pray in front of the Western Wall, the holiest place in Jerusalem? Or would Moses want to help serve in the Israeli Defense Force, known as the IDF, to protect Israel from its enemies? Israel certainly has made some strides over the years, and I believe Moses would be proud of seeing Israel and the pride the Jewish people have for its state. Most of all, I believe that Moses would be happy. Even though Moses never made it into the Promised Land himself, we as the Jewish people have done some amazing things. If it hadn't been for Moses, we would still be enslaved in the land of Egypt. We are free now, but most importantly, happy. I am happy that I get opportunities like this one because I am Jewish. I am happy to be Jewish and will always be happy to embrace what being Jewish offers me, and you all should too. Tonight, when we leave services, do something that makes you happy. Shabbat Shalom. And now I'd like to call up Rabbi Silk to make some announcements.
I've never considered what kind of Zionist Moses would be. It's an excellent question. Something great to ponder this Shabbat. A few announcements. I want to remind you that Sukkot on Sunset, our fabulous Sukkot celebration, is this Sunday. You are all invited. If you've not yet had a chance to register to let us know you're going to be here, it's not too late to do so. The event outside and in the building with activities for every age and stage begins at 4 p.m. and includes a delicious barbecue dinner. Fun and Games starts at 4. Those activities and the meal will conclude at 6:30 so that we can gather in our sukkah for a family-friendly service. And then courtesy of the Brotherhood and our scouts, a campfire with s'mores. Ooh, yes. Sukkot worship schedule includes a special Tat Sukkot event with crafts and music and snacks in the sukkah at 9:30 a.m. on Monday, which is Sukkot Day, the first day of the holiday. And then there'll be a 10:30 service here in the Proler Chapel that's an adult service. So for the little ones and the young at heart, we invite you to celebrate on Sukkot morning with us, either out in the sukkah with our crafts and snacks or in here with our beautiful liturgy and service. Immediately following tonight's service, there is a Shabbat dinner for the upper school students and their families. Please plan to join us in the Ashman Multipurpose Room for a delicious Shabbat dinner and an opportunity to visit with friends and meet with Rabbi Hayon. And finally, for those of you who are in our upper school and those of you who are 8th through 12th graders part of our service and here tonight, I want to remind you that the next TEFTY event is October 7th, which is the first night of the upper school program. And as a welcome back and a welcome to school, TEFTY is treating all the upper school students to a Raising Cane's dinner at 6:30. So we look forward to seeing all of you here and having a great welcome back dinner on that night.
Please read responsibly. We are in the habit of saying that it is not in our power to choose the parents who were allotted to us, that they were given to us by chance.
We choose the children we would like to be.
This is the only way to prolong mortality. Please rise.
It is a curious thing, the death of a loved one. We all know that our time in the world is limited and that eventually all of us will end up underneath some sheet, never to wake up. And yet it is always a surprise when it happens to someone we know. It's like walking up the stairs to your bedroom in the dark and thinking there is one more stair than there is. Your foot falls down through the air, and there's a sickly moment of dark surprise as you try and readjust the way you think of things. Life should not be a journey to the grave with the intention of arriving safely in a pretty and well-preserved body, but rather to skid and broadside in a cloud of smoke, thoroughly used up, totally worn out, and loudly proclaiming, "Wow, what a ride."
Please be seated. We have an additional simcha to celebrate tonight as our hearts overflow with thanksgiving for the blessings of our life. Aubrey Farb, if you will please stand. Celebrating his 93rd birthday, I understand. Eloheinu v'Elohei avoteinu v'imoteinu, our God, God of our mothers and our fathers. We are so thankful for the life of Aubrey Farb. Aubrey and his family, who stand as an example to our congregation of giving to this community, as a pillar of our congregation, a lover of Torah and Judaism, and what it means to be a mensch in the world. We ask for more years in good health and happiness, surrounded by those he holds nearest and dearest, as we join together in our blessings of thanks. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Shehachianu, v'kiyamanu, v'higianu, lazman hazeh. Blessed are you, Lord our God, for creating this precious life, sustaining it now for 93 spectacular, amazing years, and allowing all of us to be here tonight to celebrate this simcha, this truly joyous moment. Amen. Mazel tov. May be seated. We turn back to our service packet for a moment of silent prayer and consideration. As our service draws towards a close, we think about the lives of those who now ended have been such a precious remembrance to us, who are indeed a source of inspiration, a guiding light in our lives. We take a moment to silently consider one of the readings on the page. On this Shabbat, we remember the following members of our community and their loved ones whose yard site falls this Shabbat: Adelbert Alpert, Norman Anon, Bernice Ehrenstein, Robert Astrich, Ruth Barish, Albert Barker, Shirley Abramson Bell, Hyman Berg, Saul Burnick, Meyer Blankfield, Florence Blum, Elizabeth Brandon, Robert Harold Britton, Sydney Bromberg, Florence Oshman Davis, Irving Davis, Ida Fine, Adrian Estes Flake, Harriet Florsheim, Harry Freeman, Geraldine Friedman, George Gavry, Florence Gerber, Barnett Gershowitz, Esther Grainer, Paul Douglas Griswold, Mildred Grossman, Herbert Herzfeld, Harry Hirschhorn, Charles V. Hooks Sr., Nettie Jacob, Marjorie Janofsky, Bernard Karchmer, Rose Kahn, Lizzie Kipperman, Esther Kosberg, Seema Krajmalnik, Bertha Krakauer, Samuel J. Kuntz, Lily Lachman, Maurice Laufman, Sam Liebson, Eileen Latofsky, Dorothy Leva, Charles Levine, Esther Levinson, Fritzy Levy, Joseph Lewis, Jane Leno, Louis Liss, Jacob Littman, Sarah Etta Livitz, Walter Loeb, Abe Alex Martin, Mildred Martin, Theodora Mendelson, Pearl Merson, Clyde David Mervis, Melvin Mills, Charles Nathan, Donald Knight, Morris Noble, Herbert Paul, Suzanne Perlman, Ray Cubby Pfeffer, Cecile Phillips, Leslie Blair Plastrick, Yako Nissim Poliker, Faye Ignatoff Powell, Hyman Rychek, Philip Rich, Barry Dean Roseman, Ida Sklar Rosen, Jacob Rosen, Jerome Rosenblum, Norman Rubin, Gustav David Saper, Harry Schall, Shirley Scharf, Richard Mark Ricky Schnorr, Morris Schulman, Dorothy Siegel, Peter Seiden, David Seltzer, Isidore Shapiro, Anna Shube, Ben Singer, Esther Yetta Sline, Ruth Slusky, Joseph Spector, Irene Spencer, Francis Freeborg Stillman, Martha Stoller, Frida Stolman, Percy Sukonik, Irene Tepper, Grace Samuels Wagner, Alan Weiser, Aaron Weiss, Susan E. Wolf, Harry Zellinger, Jenny Zisman. With our griefs and sympathies mingled, we rise to praise God's name with the words of Kaddish on the final page of your service booklet. Yitzgadal v'yitzgadash shemei rabah v'yalmad yivrach yirutei v'yamlich malchutei v'chayechon v'yomechon v'chayei d'chol beit Yisrael v'agala v'yizman kariv imru amen. Yehei Shemei Rabbah Mevarach Le'olam Olamea Maya Yitbarach V'yishtabach V'yitpa'ar V'yitramam V'yitznaseh V'yitadar V'yitaleh V'yitalal Shemei D'kudushah Brihu Le'elam Minko Birchata V'shirata Tushbechata v'nechemata, da'amiram bi'alma v'imru, amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shamaya, v'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Ose shalom bimromav, hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn, and comfort to all who are bereaved among us, as we say together, amen.
Please join with me as we bring this great old melody and text to life. Shall they be seated? I can't lie no more of your darkness. All my pictures seem to fade to black and white. I'm grown tired and time stands still before me. Frozen here on the ladder of my life. Too late to save myself from falling. I took a chance and changed your way of life. You misread my meaning when I met you. Closed the door and left me blinded by the light. Everybody on the chorus, don't let the sun go down on me. Although I search myself, it's always someone else I see. It's just allow a fragment of your life to wander free. Losing everything is like the sun going down on me. I can't find, oh, the right romantic line. But see me once and see the way I feel. Don't discard me just because, yes, I mean you no harm. But these cuts I have, oh, they need love to help me heal. Everybody, don't let the sun go down on me. Although I search myself, it's always someone else I see. I just allow a fragment of your life to wander free. Losing everything is like the sun going down on me.
So thank you, Cantor, for being Tefty's rock star and cantor. Last Friday, he got the list of songs the teens requested for this service. Not like there was anything else going on this week. He did a great job. Again, thank you to Michelle and Marissa for a beautiful job. Following the benediction, I invite all of you to remain at your seats for a moment, while I will then be inviting up all of our teens to come and help lead in Kiddush and Motzi. But for now, please rise for the benediction. Mekor Haim, source of life. Whether we are 13 or 93 or anywhere around there, may we always find a craving for pondering the importance of life the way that our teens have presented to us tonight. May we hope for happiness, look for meaning, and find love wherever we seek it. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, if you're in 8th through 12th grade, join me up on the Bema. Don't make me call your names. Thank you for coming up. Okay. Here, everyone take a little kiddish thing, a little mozi thing. A little hot one, a little wine.
Did you pick the music?
Yeah.
I like it.
Thank you.
Okay, that was nice.
I'll pass on the hot
one. Okay.
Oh, they filled it up too much. How am I supposed to grab both?
That was good.
Grab a juice and a hala, come on.
Okay.
Oh, well.
Okay, did you guys all get juice at Hala? Okay. Cantor, will you help lead us in Kiddush? Ready?
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Kitchanu b'mitzvotav v'ratzavanu v'shabat kocho be'ava u'pratzon hinchilanu zikaron le'maseh v'reishit ki hu yom tefila le'mikrae kodesh zecher letziyat Mitzrayim Kivanu Vachalta Yotanu Kidashta Mikol Amim Vishabat Kochecha Be'ava Ubratzon Hinechalta Adonai Mekadesh HaShabbat Amen.
L'chaim. Everyone got some challah? Everyone up here, sorry, you'll get yours on your way out. Ready? One, two, three. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam
Hamutzi lechem min haaretz.
Amen.
Okay, Avon. Shabbat shalom, everybody.
What?